Glad you're here. We have new intelligence concerning the drug case. Finn Reinhardt has cracked that code you found.
It wasn't that difficult to solve, actually. If I'd had the complete code, it would have been faster. As we'd suspected, the code refers to a place and the missing part was probably a time. Apparently, the dealers think this is the safest way to communicate to avoid being caught. I suspect this concept has worked beautifully for some time now.
This would confirm our suspicions that we are dealing with major organized crime. Head over there now and see if you can find more information. And preferably, a new code for the location of the next meeting. And please go undercover. You don't want to draw any attention to yourself if the suspects are still there.
Dispatch, please come in. Car 2 here. What's up, Car 2? The driver of a suspicious vehicle is resisting the traffic check. It is a white coupe. We've sent you the number plate. We are in pursuit and are moving north. Copy, Car 2. I will notify cars in the vicinity. According to the computer, the white coupe is a stolen vehicle. Proceed with caution. Roger, dispatch. in. Car 11 here. What's up, dispatch? I've just sent you some coordinates. Drive to the rest stop. There's a vehicle on fire there. The fire service has already been alerted.
Roger, dispatch. We're nearly there. Dispatch, please come in. Car 11 here.
What's up, Car 11?
The fire is under control. Our colleagues from the fire...
What do we have here, then? Look, there's another code here on the wall.
Yeah, I'd better take a photo of it and send it to Finn. Then we can head straight to the next crime scene.
Good idea. That was fast. That must be Finn with his response. He's just sent us new coordinates. And it's almost the agreed time, too. Maybe we'll catch someone there.
This is turning into a real paper chase.
You're right. Let's get them.
Two lorries was loaded.
This could be our guy.
and the owner has allegedly driven off for a petrol station without paying. Car 6, this is near you. Can you take it?
Car 6 here. Did anyone take down the number plate?
Mr. Sprocker, as you might imagine, things aren't looking good for you right now.
You can't prove anything. What is it I'm supposed to have done, huh?
You were just about to sell a large quantity of drugs.
That's just an assertion for which you have no evidence.
Look, we already know everything. Your dealer couldn't wait to tell us everything he knew. And it was much more than you think.
You might be able to tell your gran that, but she probably wouldn't buy it either. You coppers just aren't any good at bluffing.
Don't change the subject. We know that you use the toilets as a meeting point for your dirty drug deals. You communicate using codes that you leave on the walls. Shall I continue? Your dealer sang like a bird. He realized that if he cooperated, it would reduce his sentence. What do you think now? Have you changed your mind?
Wait, will you offer me the same deal?
If you tell us what you know, yes. Then I'll also let the record show that you are reasonable and cooperative.
Okay, then. Go ahead and ask.
What can you tell me about the supplier?
I don't know him personally, but haven't you just arrested another of our drivers? Well, the dealer went crazy one time and shot at the driver. He must have been high. Well, if that hadn't happened, you certainly wouldn't have got on to us.
Don't be so sure about that.
Well, whatever. A shiver ran down my spine when I saw him, but not as much as in the moment when I saw you.
So, who do you sell the drugs to?
I don't sell the drugs at all. I always park the car in a different parking spot with the stuff in the boot and then deposit the key there.
And then what? Someone collects the car?
Presumably.
Thank you for your cooperation. Look, I won't pretend that you'll get out of this unpunished, but you can improve your situation if you cooperate. We're more interested in the men behind the scenes, but if you insist on it, we will make an example of a little fish like you. Do you understand?
Yes.
Good. Then let's begin.
You can save yourself the effort. I'm saying nothing.
Do you know that you've actually helped us a great deal already?
What rubbish!
If you hadn't riddled one of your buyer's cars with bullet holes, you probably wouldn't be sitting here.
What? Where?
We already know quite a bit, Mr. Figure. And if you don't cooperate, then you can add attempted murder to the drug possession and trafficking charges.
Attempted murder? I only wanted to scare the bloke.
You don't even believe that yourself. You still have a choice, you know.
Okay, okay. Ask.
Give me the name of your employer.
I don't know anyone personally. I get my orders over the phone.
Well, well, that is regrettable. So, where do the drugs come from?
No idea. I don't know.
Come on, Mr. Figure. You have to give us something.
Okay. As chance would have it, I happen to know that a large drug delivery is coming up. One of our men has been driving the Autobahns around here with a lorry over the last few weeks to find out the best route and to check out a police presence.
When are the drugs coming?
I don't know exactly. Soon.
How will we recognise the lorry?
It's got a logo from a fake haulage firm. Here, I'll draw it for you.
That might help us. You had all those drugs on you that you were just about to sell. How well do you know the buyer?
Not at all. They send me here, they send me there. I'm always meeting different buyers. I don't ask questions. My only job is to come back with the right amount of money.
And how do you arrange the meetings?
The meetings take place in Autobahn toilets. We have apprentices who leave a code in all the toilets in the area which just looks like scribbling.
Apprentices? Sounds like you're talking about a legitimate business.
Obviously, I'm not your typical businessman.
So, that's it. Our colleagues from the CID will deal with you shortly. Hello, boss. I have some important news.
I'm listening.
Apparently, there's going to be a large drug deal going down soon. We don't know when exactly, but one of the dealers has told us who's behind it and what we need to look out for. Apparently, it's a fake haulage company. A lorry with this logo on it is supposed to be transporting the drugs.
Excellent work. I'll pass the information and the logo onto our Seaver, and we'll search high and low for the lorry. If there's anything new, I'll let you know.